How much memory do you need for music production? There are a lot of myths on the internet, and especially YouTube, that you need a lot of memory in your computer as a music producer. But that's not always the case. In this video, I'll show you exactly how much memory you need in Studio One and in Logic, and how much memory you can get away with. If you're new, my name is Dexter Clark, and it's my mission to help you succeed in the music business. Make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you get all the notifications of my new videos. How much memory you need depends entirely on your situation. If you are a famous producer, yes, spec your computer out to the max in case you might need it in the future. But for the rest of us mortals, start with 8 GB and spend your hard-earned dollars on a more powerful CPU than investing it in memory. Here's the kicker that everyone seems to overlook. You can expand your memory later. You can't expand your processor or replace your processor later. Yeah, technically you could, but by the time you want to do that, it's not available anymore for your motherboard. The technology of CPUs is advancing much quicker than for memory. With memory, you don't have to be future-proof if you can't expand, but with CPUs, you have to be. Down the line, memory becomes cheaper and cheaper. So if money plays a big role, it's insanity to invest a lot in memory now. I have to make one side note here. There are computers that you can't expand later. Most Apple computers, for example, have that problem. If you want to buy such a computer, I suggest you spec it out to the max. Maybe you don't believe me, so let's dive into some projects. I have opened up Logic, and in Logic I've opened up a project with about 84 tracks. So I'll open the activity monitor, and as you can see, Logic Pro X uses about 4 GB of memory for one project. Now let's open up another project. That project has about 53 tracks. It uses about somewhat less than 2 GB of memory. Let's open another project. It has about 22 tracks. It's using about 1 GB of memory. And when we look at the total use of memory of my computer, you can see that I have 12 GB of memory in my computer, but it uses about somewhat more than 4 GB. Now let's close Logic and open Studio One. This project now uses about almost 3 GB of memory. Let's open another one. This project uses about 67 tracks. The activity monitor says somewhat more than 5 GB of memory in use. You will see with Studio One, with every project that you open, that you increase the amount of memory you use. The reason for that is because Logic and Studio One are built differently. If you open a project in Logic, then it will load from disk into the memory, and when you switch to another, it will close that project and will load another project in that memory. Studio One loads all that projects in the memory, so you need more memory to use Studio One if you work with multiple projects at the same time. You may wonder what happens to the RAM memory usage when I render out every MIDI track to audio files. Let's try it. It is lowered a bit. It's 4.67 GB. Is there a difference in memory usage when playing with rendered MIDI files and unrendered MIDI files? When I take a look at a project that I loaded in Studio One, it takes up in idle state 2.62 GB of memory, when playing 2.64 GB of memory. But when playing with rendered MIDI, that takes up 2.71 GB of memory. When I open a project in Logic, it takes up 3.44 GB of memory. When playing, 3.46 GB of memory. And when playing with rendered MIDI file, it takes up 3.47 GB of memory. The only way that I can explain that with MIDI instruments rendered, it takes up more memory is that the MIDI instruments are still loaded into the memory, and on top of that are loaded into the memory the rendered audio files. So less than 8 GB, but you need to have some headroom for your operating system left. So with 8 GB, that would suffice in my situation. I have to say this situation changes, however, when you use a lot of sample-based instruments. And in my case, I don't. I'm still saving up for Kontakt. But if you have Kontakt or another sample-based plugins, you need more memory. What the difference is between a synthesizer and a sample-based instrument is that a synthesizer calculates sound when you want to do something with that synthesizer. A sample-based plugin used samples. So all those samples, it needs to load into the memory so it is quickly available, because loading from hard disk real time is too slow. Let's say you have 88 samples of an instrument, because a piano has 88 keys. Then if every sample is 1 megabyte, it takes up 88 megabytes of memory to load everything in the memory. When you have 10 instruments of 88 megabytes, that is 880 megabytes, almost 1 gigabyte of memory. That is if you don't render out the MIDI files, and that memory usage is on top of your typical memory usage of your DAW and the rest of your instruments. Let's take a more extreme case. For example, those samples are 2 megabytes each and you have 20 instruments. Then you have about 4 gigabytes of memory that you use with the sample-based plugins. On top of that, your 4 gigabytes of your regular instruments and your reverbs and your DAW. And so that's 8 gigabytes. And on top of that, you need to have some headroom for your OS. And then 8 gigabytes is a little bit on the small side. So the next step would be 16 gigabytes of memory in total. This math is pretty consistent with the numbers Native Instrument publishes on their website for their commonly used plugin Kontakt. If you want to load 4 of those projects in Studio One, not in Logic, then indeed you come to a 32 gigabytes of memory that you need, and you still need some headroom for your operating system. I hope you can see that this is an extreme case, memory's worst case scenario, that you really need to pull some rabbits out of your head to get to the numbers that everyone talks about. You might still not believe me that you don't need that much memory that everyone talks about. Well, let's take a look at the sites of the software makers. ImageLine from FL Studio. 8 gigabytes is probably enough. 16 gigabytes is likely more than you need. Persona Studio One, 4 gigabytes of RAM minimum, 8 gigabytes or more recommended. Ableton Live, 4 gigabytes of RAM, 8 gigabytes or more recommended. Apple Logic Pro X, 4 gigabytes of RAM. Okay, now we know about the memory, but what about the processor? Click on the link here in the screen for my video about the best processor for music production. Click on the link here in the screen for the best laptop for music production, and here for the best computer for music production. Links to all those videos are also in the description below.